Well, we now are going on with the third session that we have interrupted before lunch. The topic, as you remember, is the business register as a supplier of legal and reliable data. Now, I would like to invite Lars Peder Brekk to speak. Lars is the general director of Brønnøysund in Norway. The Brønnøysund Register Center develops and operates many of the nation's most important registers and electronic solutions, administering the Norwegian public reporting portal, Altinn. So, Lars, you have the floor.
Thank you very much, dear Annika, ECRF, and all the friends. Thanks for this opportunity to give some information on the Norwegian e-government infrastructure. Let's hope it's work. Yes. First, I will give you a very short overview of the Brønnøysund Register Center, BRC. Then I will, in a few words, explain the system of how to register business enterprises in Norway. And at last, I will say something more precise about electronic registration, digitalizing procedures, and our exciting dialogue platform, Altinn. As you know, we are located in Brønnøysund, mid-Norway. Headquarters is there. And I have a district office in Oslo and up north in Narvik. I like to present this like this. This is our organization map, and as you see, we have down on the page, you see we have three main production or operational departments: management of registers, simplification and communication, and Altinn and Ceres. We can also call this the BRC infrastructure for management of registers, simplification and user communication, and digitalized dialogue between public authorities, all businesses and voluntary enterprises, and all inhabitants in Norway. In BRC, we manage and operate 17 different public registers, plus the dialogue platform Altinn, and also Ceres, the metadata repository. Altinn is the most important precondition for digitalizing the communication between public sector and private business enterprises and inhabitants in Norway. The most important registers are listed in this figure, and I will mention a few of them. The register of mortgaged movable properties, registers entitlements and mortgage security interest in movable assets. It's a very important financial instrument for enterprises. And it's secured amount equals 6 times the Norwegian state budget. The register of annual accounts, the next, collects annual accounts, including the auditor reports from all private and public limited companies, saving banks, mutual insurance companies, and petroleum enterprises. We also have the EBR, European Business Register, provides access to information in most European business registers. The Register of Business Enterprises registers all Norwegian and foreign business enterprises in Norway. And we also have a Register of Bankruptcies. This register registers bankruptcy estates, debtors in liquidation, and compulsory liquidations. And the Register of Bankruptcies also registers persons disqualified from operating in business. And at last, I can mention the Central Coordinating Register for Legal Entities, CCR. This register registers basic data about legal entities to coordinate information on business and industry that resides in various public registers. Initial registration of all legal entities before registration elsewhere. It assigns a nationwide unique ID applied in all contexts when referring to legal entities. So a little bit about the central coordinating register for legal entities. I don't think other nations have the same system as we have here. And this is probably our most important register, the central coordinating register for legal entities, or we call it CCR. And it is one of three main public registers in Norway. The other two is the National Population Register and the Land Register. In CCR, we identify all Norwegian entities, give them their organization number. And we have a kind of first-in rule registration with one of our associated registers. For example, the Register of Businesses requires also registration with CCR. And also we have the last rule, last out rule, it says that the striking out from CCR requires also striking of the associated registers. And it's important, there is an obligation for all to update and exchange data. And since the 1st of July 2005, all public registers and public administrations in Norway are obliged to reuse the data registered in the CCR, including the organization number. This picture is kind of Brønnøysund as a register hotel. When you, for example, register in a new business enterprise, as I told you, you also at the same time will be registered in the CCR, and you get your unique organization number. And all the 17 registers are a part of this register hotel. And I think in the future we will grow. So a little bit about the input procedure. When you found a company, there are two steps. You found it and you register it. And with regard to funding, to the founding procedures, we are now working with our upcoming electronic possibility. I hope that we can deliver this during the summer. Electronic registration can be done by anyone. It's an electronic form, pre-populated information, for example, from the National Population Register. And there are automatic checkpoints, for example, the financial supervisory authority is the register of company accounts and the register of bankruptcies. For example, if an appointee is deceased, an appointee disqualified, and the register of bankruptcies communicates, the auditor loses his authorization. The system has also built-in information derived from acts and regulations, thus providing legal support during the processing of cases. Minors, for example, are not allowed to be board members according to the Company Act. Submitters receive an error message before they submit. It's important to underline that we are streamlining the processes between the business registers, the Statistics Bureau, tax authorities, and welfare involved in business registration. And cooperation among different public authorities is the key element of business registration reform in Norway. So a little bit more about, let's start there, a little bit more about Altinn. Altinn is the most important Norwegian digitalizing motor, let's call it this. It's a digitalized dialogue platform between public authorities, for example, the tax authorities, the welfare authorities, the authorities for giving you a certificate to drive a car, etc., etc. And it's very important for us because Altinn gives us the possibility to digitalize the processes. And in Altinn, an application must be digitally signed. If the form has to be signed by several persons, the form will be transferred through Altinn to the next person to sign. And for example, for a few days ago, I was in Alicante and I signed my tax report to the Norwegian authorities from Alicante through Altinn. Before submitting the form, the applicant may send a link to the form by email to someone with a request for them to check the form from him or her. Altinn also offers functionality for submitting a form that someone else has started to fill in. Once the form is submitted, a receipt is issued immediately. This receipt can be retrieved in the submitter's message box archive section. Here, the submitter can view a list of forms submitted when they were submitted and the reference number assigned to each form on submission. Different roles in the business registers, for example, are pre-assigned rights in Altinn. Employees at auditors or accountants firm must be given permission to perform work for the clients. This is done by delegating client roles from the board or the general manager. So, in a way, I can say that 100%, also this is the value with Altinn, 100% of Norway inhabitants over the age of 15 have a unique user account in Altinn. And 100% of Norwegian enterprises, both commercial and voluntary, has a user account and a mailbox in Altinn. So through Altinn, BRC are in contact with the whole Norwegian population and all enterprises. 4 million inhabitants and 1 million enterprises are unique users today. And let's say it this way, Altinn is used to register the names of newborn children, choice of school, culture applications, tax returns, as I explained for you, etc. And enterprises come into existence and expire in Altinn. The Central Coordination Register for Legal Entities, Electronic Information, the Bankruptcy Service, all this is linked together. In our work on modernization, simplification, and improvement, this modern digital infrastructure is essential. We cannot go further without this infrastructure. And it gives reduced costs for the public authorities and for business enterprises. And we say that we have used about 1 billion Norwegian kroner during 10 years to build Altinn, and the saving in the enterprises is 15 million billions of kroner for these years. So the biggest, somebody thinks that Altinn is just an internet portal, and this is of course a big misunderstanding. Altinn is an internet portal as well, but Altinn's strength lies in the platform itself. This digital infrastructure that links together registers, public agencies, municipalities, enterprises, and the country inhabitants. Altinn, and this is important, Altinn is based on open standards and open interfaces. And it's based on shared understanding of the data, what's known as semantic interoperability. That is why the Brønnøysund Register Center has also invested so much in the semantic register for electronic collaboration, CERIS, as we call it. And in the future, the Brønnøysund Register Center and Altinn can and should be a foundation on which to facilitate innovation and create value in the private sector and in the public sector. In the future, I see a closer cooperation between the public sector and the private sector through Altinn and this technology that we use there. So far, we see that the service owner, and there is today 41 different public agencies using Altinn. They have enjoyed great success in their digitalizations work. We are way ahead of many other countries in this area, I think. Reporting of annual accounts, for example, will be 100% from the 1st of January 2015, as it's made mandatory by law. And let's also say about how the business enterprises likes Altinn, this system, because I think some of the business enterprises, as I've heard here, don't like the registers, they don't like the systems. In Norway, they love them, because this gives lower costs, simplification and better data between the enterprises, the tax authorities, the welfare authorities, etc. So, do you all hear our, the picture of our public agencies? I often say that this infrastructure can be used more. It should be used more because we have invested a lot of money in it, but we cannot do everything for everybody. We cannot do everything for everybody. That's also important to know. We have to find out how to use it more. And in the future, we will reduce the cost for both the industry, the business enterprises, and the public agencies through Altinn and through the Brønnøysundregistersenteret. Thank you very much.